Ladies and gentlemen, the starting lineup for the Detroit Red Wings. On defense number 3, Steve Chiasson. On defense number 16, Vladimir Constantino. At left wing number 25, John O'Grodnik. At right wing number 22, Dino Cicerelli. For your Toronto Maple Leafs. On defense number 4, Dave Ellis. On defense number 23, Todd Gill. At left wing number 14, Dave Andrechuk. At right wing number 9, Glenn Anderson. At center number 93, Doug Gilmore. Starting in goal number 29, Felix Puttman. Ladies and gentlemen, will you please rise and join John McDermott in the singing of our national anthems.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hail at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in. Still there, oh say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the
shoot it and pass it. They've made one change at forward. Gerard Gallant is out with a Charlie horse, and he's replaced by the veteran John O'Grodner. Cribben, Conroy, Hiller, and Cummins are here but not playing.
Felix Potvin promises to hold his cool here in Game 3. Really, he has held the Leafs close for the first period of both games at Detroit.
And on defense, the Leafs will go with the same six that played in Joe Louis Arena in Game 1 and 2. And on the forward position, they've inserted Manderville and taken out Crucial Niski. As well, Osborne is back in the lineup. Borschevsky, McGill, Berhowski hurt. The other four here, but not dressed.
The referee is Mark Fawcett. On the lines, Kevin Collins and Brian Murphy. Yzerman, Cicerelli, and John O'Grodnik. Starting up front for Detroit, Konstantinov and Chase on the defenseman. That is Gill, who's on with Ellick to start on the Maple Leaf blue line. Gilmore, Anderson, and Kachuk go in over the line. Chevalier coming out of the net. Gill can't stop it, and Ellick is hustling back, and he does a pretty good job getting back in front of Fedorov. As the Red Wings change quickly, Ellick got a high stick. There's going to be a Detroit penalty right off the bat. 30 seconds into the game. Ellick was hit with a high stick from Fedorov. There's Fedorov, and we'll get a look at Ellick now, as the referee has a look at him too.
Well, the Detroit Red Wings came out. They really wrapped Doug Gilmore on the first shift. And early in the game, 30 seconds into it, Fedorov high sticks Ellick as he's chasing him behind the net. He hooked him once, twice, and then gets him right there in the face. Fedorov very fortunate that Ellick's not cut. And Gilmore comes out and lays a good one on Konstantinov, the toughest and most rugged Red Wing defenseman.
A minor penalty to Fedorov. High sticking is the call. Pat Burns was saying yesterday, it's almost imperative that the Maple Leafs get a lead against these Red Wings. Well, they have an early power play now, 30 seconds into the game. Long shot wide of the Maple Leaf net. Toronto with Mironov. That is Gill with the puck. Gilmore circles behind him. Gill starts it off. Up the center, Mironov. He hammers it in there. Sean Burr, a penalty killer for Detroit, can't clear it. Chason gets an opportunity now. It comes to Gill, however. Shot! It was screened but went wide. Mironov poked it ahead. Now Mironov lets one fly. Right in there! And Collin looking for it, can't find it. Tim Chevalier going down. And the Leafs come close. And what a noisy crowd tonight at Maple Leaf Gardens.
The Leafs have never been ahead in this series. They've been even for 23 minutes and 14 seconds of the first 120, and they've been behind for a minute 36. The first goal would be the best news the Maple Leafs could ever get here in Game 3 at Maple Leaf Gardens, and they came fairly close to getting it on that point shot that Chevalier found before Anderson and Cullen could get their sticks on it.
Minute 26 left in the Red Wing penalty. Fedorov is in the box for high sticking. Cullen against Yzerman on the draw. The Red Wings, Konstantinov into the corner. Here's Yzerman, and he easily finds the gap between the two defensemen. It's all the way back. Gill chased by Yzerman. So he played it in back of the net. Mironov waiting for Gilmore, and he comes around the net. Mironov's pass to Todd Gill. He's up over the Red Wing line. Gill is cutting from the corner. He's in back of the net. He's tied up momentarily. Chuck comes in to get a hand. Cullen trying to race for it against Yzerman. Yzerman got there first and cleared it. Red Wings are changing. 50 seconds left of the penalty. No score. First period. Game 3. It is Gill again at center. And he shoots it in. He is not 100%. Back spasms was the problem with Todd Gill. He's on for a long shift there. Forechecking, trying to kill off this penalty. Clark on the ice for the first time. Got it in. Here's Cecil. He can't handle the pass. Cecil back of the net. Has a chance to move it out to the line, and Ellick winds up. No shot. It's off the stick of Mironov. He's hit hard on the in after him. It is played on the boards to the line, but not out. Red Wings center it. Hooked in high off the glass. Allen tied up. It is Pearson getting loose. He's over the Detroit blue line. Pearson's pass back. Shot. Shuttle day. Three Red Wings hot on it and come back. Up to center ice. Primo going in offside.
Here at Maple Leaf Gardens, Murray knows his speedy more talented wings. If they cannot allow the Leafs to outwork him, he thinks they can beat them. Burns wants a little more discipline to go along with the physical play.
3:17 into the opening period.